Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah wahda wa salatu wa salamu ala man la nabiyya ba'da. Dear respected viewers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to another brand new episode of the program entitled Towards the Origin, watched live on Sky 734, and also to all of those who have joined us via our social media network, which is the Facebook. Thank you very much and welcome to the program. Also, you can watch this program live on our website, which is www.chsuk.tv. And inshallah, the repeat of the program will also be aired on the following day. And later on, you'll also find us on our YouTube channel. Our tonight's discussion will be on the topic Quranic art. Now, what does Quran talk about the art? Now, the field, it's so vast, it's so big that it's very difficult to do justice to discuss in one episode in an hour. But inshallah, we'll try and touch on the basic aspect of the da'wah when it comes to spreading the message of Islam. How can we use the form of art to spread the message of Islam, to spread the message in a way that people can understand in a simplified way, in a different way? There's poetry, there's literature, there's language. All of these are part of art. Yes, the extension of it is also very huge, but today we'll try and discuss about the basic form of art. What does the Quran say? How can we implement? And should we nurture the talent and quality people possess in this field? And how we can educate our viewers and ourselves as well to enhance and engage in this field of work? To discuss this, we have got with us our regular guest, who is the respected Imaam and Khateeb, or in fact, one of the Imaam and Khateeb of London Central Mosque and Islamic Cultural Center, Fadilatul Shaykh Kazi Lutfur Rahman. Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Welcome to the program, and thank you very much for joining in.
Barakallahu feekum. Thank you very much.
Indeed. Now, let's start. First of all, the word art, it's normally associated generally, understanding of people, general. It's a field of secular, it's a field that people who might not be considered to be religious, it's a field that people would be associating it with something not too Islamic, right, if we have to put in a simple term. Yeah. Now, how would you discuss that?
طيب. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ثم أما بعد. After praising Allah and sending salam and salutations to the noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, I testify that there is none worthy of worship except Allah. He is one and he has no partners. And I also testify that the noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the final messenger and slave of Allah, the Almighty. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala created this universe. He created these heavens and the earth. And not only just he created, but he also adorned the universe. He also beautified the world and earth, the sab'a samawat. And we see this sense of jamal, the sense of beauty in the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is also considered as a jameel. And there is a famous hadith of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, "Inna Allah jameel wa yuhibbul jamal." Verily, Allah the Almighty is beautiful and he loves the beauty. আমাদের প্রিয় নবী মুহাম্মদ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম বলছেন যে অবশ্যই আল্লাহ পাক রব্বুল আলামিন সুন্দর এবং উনি সৌন্দর্যকে পছন্দ করেন। আল্লাহ পাক রব্বুল আলামিন এই পৃথিবীকে অত্যন্ত সুন্দরভাবে সৃষ্টি করেছেন। শুধু উনি সৃষ্টি করেন নাই বরং পৃথিবীটাকে অত্যন্ত সুন্দরভাবে আল্লাহ পাক রব্বুল আলামিন সৃষ্টি করেছেন।
Now the definition of সুন্দর বা বিউটি হচ্ছে কিন্তু প্রত্যেকের কাছে ভিন্ন।
Yes.
আমার কাছে হয়তো একটা জিনিস সুন্দর লাগতে পারে, হয়তো আপনার কাছে এটি নাও লাগতে পারে বা আরেকজনের কাছে ওইটি সদা পছন্দ নাও হতে পারে।
জি জি।
Now how would you define the সুন্দর or beauty?
ওটা আমরা দেখবো যে মেজরিটি লোকরা কি বলছে, মানে what's the majority? মানদণ্ড কি কোরআন হাদিসের মানদণ্ড অনুযায়ী? অবশ্যই কোরআন হাদিসে তো মানদণ্ড আছে, কিন্তু সাধারণ ক্ষেত্রে আমরা দেখতে পারি যে সংখ্যা গরিষ্ঠরা কি বলছে ওটা সুন্দর নাকি। দু একজন হয়তো অসুন্দর বলতেই পারে, কিন্তু সংখ্যাগরিষ্ঠ লোকেরা যদি বলে থাকে সুন্দর, তাহলে এটাই আসলে সুন্দর।
তার মানে হচ্ছে প্রিন্সিপাল, বেসিক প্রিন্সিপাল কোরআন এবং হাদিসের আলোকে, এবং যদি ডাইরেক্ট কোনো জিনিস মেনশন না করা থাকে তাহলে ইজমা, যেটা মেজরিটি,
এটা মেজরিটি বলা যেতে পারে। ওকে, সো আল্লাহ সুবহানাহু ওয়া তাআলা ক্রিয়েটেড দ্য ইউনিভার্স এন্ড হি সেড, অ্যাকচুয়ালি হি কোল্ড দ্য পিপল অফ দ্য ওয়ার্ল্ড এন্ড সেড, ওয়াজায়্যানাহা লিন-নাযিরিন, দ্যাট আই হ্যাভ বিউটিফাইড দিস universe for the viewers or for its viewers. এই পৃথিবীকে কিন্তু আমি অত্যন্ত সুন্দরভাবে সৃষ্টি করেছি। ওয়াজায়্যানাহা, তাজিন শব্দের অর্থ হচ্ছে সৌন্দর্য এবং বিউটিফিকেশন। সো নট অনলি হি ক্রিয়েটেড দ্য ইউনিভার্স বাট অলসো হি মেড ইট বিউটিফুল, ওয়াজায়্যানাহা লিন-নাযিরিন। Then we find Allah Tabaraka Ta'ala is calling upon people. উনি লুক আদেরকে ডাকতেছেন আল্লাহ পাক রব্বুল আলামিন মানব গোষ্ঠীকে বলতেছেন যে আফালাম ইয়ানযুরু ইলা সামাই, don't they look at the universe, don't they look at the heaven, the sama, the sky, afalam yanzuru ila samai fawqahum, above them, unader upore je allah pak rabbul alamin ottonto sundor bhabe ekta akash srishti korechen ora ki dekhte pare na, afalam yanzuru ila samai fawqahum kayfa banaynaha, how we have created or how we created. And then he says, not only just banayna, but he says also wazayyannaha. Kayfa banaynaha wazayyannaha, and how we beautified the heaven, the sky. And then he says, وَمَا لَهَا مِن فُرُوج, and we don't see any rift in it. We don't find any separation in it. Oi akash ke Allah pakram eto shundor bhabe srishti korechen je akasher moddhe amra kono khut amra kono dhoroner error ba fault amra pacchi na. وَمَا لَهَا مِن فُرُوج. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heaven and he made it beautiful. Really, when we look at the heaven, we see the heaven in the sky in London. And then you travel for hundreds and hundreds of miles, and you go to the other part of the world, and you still see the same heaven that Allah created. So really, it's a beautification and a sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sign of His existence. Allah pak rabbul alaminer je existence ekta ekta kintu praman aya ba chinno. And then we find Quran also speaks about the earth, the ardh. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Qaf again, wal ardha madadnaha, that we have created the earth, madadnaha, and expanded the earth. Amra kintu ei jomin ke proshosto korechi. Shudhu just srishti kori nai, but proshosto. Allah pak bolchen je jinishta kintu ottonto jomin ta ke ottonto proshosto kore uni srishti korechen. Wal ardha madadnaha wa alqayna fiha rawasi. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he put everywhere or allocated everywhere the mountains, the heavy mountains. What is the purpose of mountains? So that the mountains keep the earth firm. এই দুনিয়াকে পৃথিবীতে পৃথিবীকে সুন্দরভাবে এটাকে স্থাপন করার জন্য এবং এটাকে কন্ট্রোল করার জন্য আল্লাহ পাক রব্বুল আলামিন চারিদিকে পাহাড় সৃষ্টি করেছেন। ওয়াজআলনা ফিহা ওয়া আলকাইনা ফিহা রাওয়াসিয়া ওয়া আমবাতনা ফিহা মিন কুল্লি যাওজিন বাহিদ, এন্ড দেন আল্লাহ ক্রিয়েটেড পেয়ার্স এন্ড থিংস ইন পেয়ার্স অন আর্থ, zawjin bahid, everything you see, like genders, masculine, feminine, whether man, human beings, or other creation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, gender maddumuni, প্রত্যেকটা জিনিসকে উনি সৃষ্টি করেছেন। মানব গোষ্ঠী হতে পারে, যে পশু পাখি হতে পারে, ইনসেক্ট হতে পারে, পোকামাকড় হতে পারে, সব কিছু কিন্তু আল্লাহ পাক রাব্বুল আলামিন জেন্ডারে সৃষ্টি করেছেন। মিনকুল্লি জাউজ, তারপর আল্লাহ পাক বলেন বাহিজ, at the end he concludes the ayah by saying bahij. Bahij shabdo ortho hocche jamal wa husn, ortho sundorjo ebong sundor kore Allah pak rabbul alamin srishti korechen. Then also we find fa anbatna fiha hadaiqa dhata bahja, fa anbatna bihi hadaiqa dhata bahja. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he created and he caused the gardens to be on earth. And again, that bahja, that the beauty, the gardens of beauty. Now, for example, London, we see in London, like, there are parks everywhere, there are beautiful gardens and parks everywhere filled up with trees and grass and nature. And people love going and seeing those beauty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Now, you can have a problem at say Muslim deshe kintu abar environmental friendly, but responsibility towards environment, we don't see that. If we come to the western part of the world, we do notice that there's utmost importance for looking after the environment and for the health purpose and other benefit, that scientific way we know that, and even you have mentioned. Why is that?
So, you see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling Muslims and the ummah and the people in general to actually take care of the nature. And we find this in numerous Quranic verses as well. But unfortunately, as Muslims, actually, we probably, it's just a self-criticism. We have done very well in many ways, but we also fail in some ways. But I think we do need to take care of our nature. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed some of the countries in the Muslim world with beautiful nature. For example, even if you speak about Bangladesh, it's a very beautifully, a naturally rich and rich country. And even particularly if you talk about Sylhet, for example, is also very, very beautiful. When we go to the back home, we see like the beautiful nature. So anyway, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he blessed some of the countries and some of the places with natural beauty. But we need to take care of the nature.
And is it because a lack of knowledge? That's why we do not have
And general maybe backwardness and failure in many ways. But but again,
Understand the importance of the nature and the environment. Is that correct?
Yes, definitely. So فَأَنْبَتْنَا بِهِ حَدَائِقَ ذَاتَ بَهْجَةٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created. উনি কিন্তু সুন্দর করে এই গার্ডেন এবং এই পার্কগুলোকে আল্লাহ পাকের মধ্যে সৃষ্টি করেছেন. And then we find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about the bahar, the ocean. And the purpose of mentioning these verses so we can understand the sense of beauty, the jamal and ihsas bil jamal, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created things beautifully. Not only just He created, but He is trying to plant a seed of beauty in the hearts and minds of human beings. So it is not about being just like gloomy and dislike the beautiful things and dislike the joyful things in the world. But also, as long as it's not imbalanced or it's not exaggerated, we can enjoy the jamal and the beauty of the world, and we can have the sense of beauty. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَهُوَ الَّذِي سَخَّرَ الْبَحْرِ. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He created the bahar, the ocean. لِتَأْكُلُوا مِنْهُ لَحْمًا طَرِيًّا. So that you eat the fishes and different types of food from the bahar. وَتَسْتَخْرِجُوا مِنْهُ حِلْيَةً تَلْبَسُونَهَا. And you get things out from the ocean, like jewelries and you know, different pearls and things that come out from ocean. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about the animals. Well, an'ama. And animals are also beautiful creation of Allah. And particularly if you talk about the jamal,
camel.
Ibil, camel. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He speaks in the Quran by saying, أَفَلَا يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَى الْإِبِلِ كَيْفَ خُلِقَتْ. Don't they look how Allah beautifully created the ibil, the camel? Ora ki dekhena je Allah pak rabbul alamin kibhabe ottonto shundor kore camel ke srishti korechen ba ut ke srishti korechen. So here He says, wal an'ama khalaqaha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created the an'am, the animals that walk on earth. لَكُمْ فِيهَا دِفْ. What are the benefits of the animals? That you get heat and warmth from the animals. For example, we make wool, lamb wool, and different types of wool. We make coats and jackets and things out of the skin of the animals. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, لَكُمْ فِيهَا دِفْءٌ وَمَنَافِعُ لِلنَّاسِ, and a lot of benefits for people. مَنَافِعُ لِلنَّاسِ. And then He says, وَمِنْهَا تَأْكُلُونَ, and you also eat from it. You benefit from the animals. So He's saying that you benefit in all of those different ways from the animals. And then, وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا جَمَالٌ. And He says, after mentioning that verse about the animals, He says, وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا جَمَالٌ. You see the beauty in the animals. Now, for example, when you go to the desert, you see the amra jokhon morubhumite jai, amra jokhon Asia ba Africa deshgulote amra jokhon jai, tokhon amra dekhte pari je kibhabe Allah pak rabbul alamin oi poshu guloke srishti korechen. So walakum fiha jamal, etar moddhe Allah pak shundorjo diyechen. Walakum fiha jamal hina turihuna wa hina tasrahun, jokhon ora rest korche ebong jokhon ora baire jacche. In every ways you see the jamal in them, you see the beauty in the animals that Allah created.
Tar mane hocche amader daitto shudhu manusher protio na, animals ba poshu pakhi tader protio ache
obosshoi.
Na ekhane jara animal friendly ache, especially in the western world, they are slightly concerned about the animal welfare. Now how would you respond to that?
Well, every creation that Allah created, we need to deal and treat them with kindness and mercy and ihsan. And therefore, we find a famous prophetic narration, which is, إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَتَبَ الْإِحْسَانَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. Verily, Allah the Almighty, He written and He wrote the ihsan in everything. Now, as long as the creation is not harmful, then we must take care of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as long as it's not harmful towards the human being.
Now, that means that those animals that are consumable, that human being can consume, especially as Muslim, that are lawful, that means it needs to, we need to adhere to the principle of Islam when it comes to consuming the meat as well. Is that correct?
Definitely, of course. Again, even when it comes to slaughter the animals, Prophet Muhammad SAW is saying, like, you know, be kind and merciful, so and have compassion towards the animals.
Because many a times people have a misunderstanding that Islam is ruthless when it comes to animals.
No.
So that means there are certain principles laid down and guidelines laid down by the Quran.
And I think it's our understanding, how we perceive things, how we understand things. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whenever He makes something like law, lawful and he gives a guideline, it has to be with the mercy and compassion.
Now, এখানে কিন্তু আমাদের মুসলমানরা মাঝে মাঝে when they look at the media and the news that see, and sometimes the doubt comes into the head.
Yes.
Now, what would your message be to us, especially to our Muslim brothers and sisters, that when they have doubt?
Yes, I think we need to, if there is any doubt, then first of all, this needs to be removed through a good consultation with the scholars,
education.
Scholars of Islam, and of course, through also reading the right and correct literature. But most importantly, I would say, it's good to go through with a qualified scholar of Islam.
So that means when the Quran say, ask the knowledgeable person.
Yes.
Is that what you're referring to?
That, ask the people of knowledge if you have any doubt or if you do not know about something.
And then it's also our responsibility to ensure that we educate ourselves, learn ourselves,
sure, yes,
rather than believing in what we have heard.
Yes, no, of course, that's true. And a lot of time, like, we really are misguided by many kind of thoughts and understandings and ideologies. But that need to be, again, clarified with the scholars of Islam. And really, when we do that, a lot of things removes. And we come back to the original understanding. মানে আমাদেরকে এই জিনিসগুলো কিন্তু আমাদের মিসআন্ডারস্ট্যান্ডিংগুলোকে আমরা দূর করতে হবে কোয়ালিফাইড স্কলার যারা আছে ওনাদের সাথে আলোচনা করে যে কোনো যদি মিসআন্ডারস্ট্যান্ডিং চলে আসে আমাদের মধ্যে বাট জেনারেলি উই হ্যাভ টু বি কাইন্ড উইথ এভরিথিং অ্যান্ড দ্যাটস দি প্রিন্সিপল অফ ইসলাম ওয়ালা আই মিন ইস দ্য অরিজিনাল কন্ডিশন অফ দ্য মুসলিম ইজ সালাম দ্য পিস. It is not what the turmoil is, as some people try to, promote, or some people try to say. But the original condition is the peace. That's the actual condition. And Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam always tried to maintain the peace in society and community. Now, coming back to the discussion, Jamal of Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala, the beautiful creation, and then he says, "Wal khayl wal bighala." The khayl is horse. Wal bighal, the mule. So Allah created the khayl wal bighal and hamir and even donkeys. لِتَرْكَبُوهَا so that you ride on them.
As a mode of transport.
A transport. And of course, even today, if you go to some parts of the world, you find still these things are used as transport.
We do see in the royal family weddings even.
And I see, yes, that's right. And for general day-to-day use, we see even in Egypt and in other parts of the Muslim world, people still use the donkeys and as just normal
as a mode of transport.
Yes. Okay. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, "Wal khayla wal bighala wa hamila litarkabuha." And then what does he say at the end? Wazina. Zina means beauty. So this is again shundorjo. Allah pak rabbul alamin oi pranigulo ko srishti korechen ebong porobortite uni bolchen ayater shesher dike je wazina eta tomader jonno shundorjo. So ihsas, enjoying the beauty and being happy with the beautiful things is something that required by Allah and required by Islam. So it's not something, you know, as some people try to say, Islam is about being unhappy, upset, and very angry.
Too much rules to follow.
Yes, and আমাদের মধ্যে অনেক কিন্তু রাগান মানে রাগ মনোভাব হয় যে আপনি যদি একজন রিলিজিয়াস ব্যক্তি হন আপনি যদি একজন ধার্মিক ব্যক্তি হন তাহলে আপনাকে রাগান্বিত হতে হবে আপনাকে এক ধরনের গ্লুমি হতে হবে এই ধরনের আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ডিং আমাদের অনেকের মধ্যে আছে কিন্তু আসলে সত্যিকার অর্থে কি এটাই আমাদের প্রিয় নবী মুহাম্মদ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম কি এরকমই ছিলেন ওনার ব্যবহার ওনার আখলাকতে আমরা কী দেখতে পাই এবং আল্লাহ পাক রব্বুল আলামিন আমাদেরকে কী বলছেন এবং কোন দিকে আল্লাহ পাক রাম আমাদেরকে দাওয়াত দিচ্ছেন সো জিনা ইহসাস বিল জামাল অ্যান্ড দ্য সেন্স অফ বিউটি ইজ ইম্পর্টেন্ট দেন উই লুক এট দ্য ক্রিয়েশন অফ দ্য হিউম্যান ক্রিয়েশন হাউ আল্লাহ ক্রিয়েটেড হি সেড ওয়াসাওয়ারাকুম ফাআহসানা সুওয়ারাকুম হি ফ্যাশনড ইউ অ্যান্ড হি ডিজাইনড ইউ অ্যান্ড হি মেড দ্য বেস্ট ডিজাইন for you as human being. Wasawwarakum. So, you know, some of us, we might think, oh, how Allah created me, my skin color, my look, my size. You know, we must now, not be, upset and unhappy with about our own looks.
Now, there are reasons to that as well. We are never content with what we have. Now, the reason being is we are also not fair and just to our system. Mm. For instance, we do notice on social media network, let's assume either whether it be the WhatsApp profile picture or Facebook or even Instagram, to say, every single day we notice, whether it's ulama or non-ulama or general public, they change the pictures, they upload their pictures, wherever they go, which holidays they have gone, of their looks.
Yes,
now,
yes.
Is that not creating a doubt or some sort of discontentment within those who are less able or think themselves as inferior to others?
Yes. Of course, first of all, it goes back to the intention of the individual. So I can't judge everybody in a similar way. But generally, I think whatever that is unnecessary, considered unnecessary, must be or should be, should one should try the best to avoid. মানে যেই কোনো জিনিস অপ্রয়োজনীয় হয়ে থাকে অযথা হয়ে থাকে এটা কিন্তু অ্যাভয়েড করা আই থিঙ্ক ইটস সামথিং দ্যাট ইম্পর্টেন্ট
ডিফাইন দ্যাট ইজ স্লাইটলি লিটল বিট ডিফিকাল্ট লাইক হু ডিফাইন্স
আই নো হাউ ইউ ইয়েস বাট দেন अगेन দেন अगेन আই সে সাম টাইম লাইক থিংস ক্যান বি জাজড বাই দ্য মেজরিটি হোয়াট দ্য মেজরিটি পিপল থিঙ্ক এন্ড হোয়াট দে সে অ্যাবাউট ইট
এন্ড ইন দিস কনটেক্সট উড বি আ লিটল বিট স্লাইটলি ডিফারেন্ট অ্যাজ অ্যাজ মেজরিটি উড বি আপলোডিং দ্য পিকচারস অ্যান্ড শেয়ারিং দ্যাট
আই থিঙ্ক দিস ইজ সামথিং দ্যাট উই নিড টু বি উই নিড টু রিডিউস এন্ড মেবি engage on more useful work.
Okay.
Life is very temporary and we should do much more important things. And we all waste our time. And this is a big problem that we have.
The social research have shown that how much we have time we have wasted. I mean, koto shomoy noshto kore, mullyoban shomoy noshto kore, just using the social media network.
Yes, that's right.
We have seen deprivation of sleep. We have seen the mental illness. Mm-hmm. We have seen a lot of there is a correlation between social media, between those kind of things related to the individual health as well.
Definitely.
এখানে আরেকটা বিষয় আছে ইমানের একটু হয়তো পরিচয় থাকতে পারে যে ওয়াই শুড আই কনসিডার যে অমুক আমার থেকে বাই লুকসে হয়তো সুন্দর হতে পারে বা স্কিন টোন হয়তো
সুন্দর ইউ সি দিস ইজ এ কম্পিটিশন হুইচ হ্যাজ বিন হুইচ ইজ এগেইন কন্ট্রিবিউশন অফ দ্য মডার্ন ওয়ার্ল্ড মডার্ন টাইম সোসাইটি এন্ড রিয়েলি উই নিড টু go back to the original sources and see like what our creator is telling us. For example, when we say laqad khalaqna al-insana fi ahsani taqwim, that verily we created the human beings in the best form and we fashioned them in the best form, or ami manob gustike ottonto sundor bhabe srishti korechi ebong prottek manush kintu sundor sundor unar mane in his own way in her own way.
So that's
every human being is
very
beautiful.
Very valid point you've mentioned, that from his own way rather than we utilize someone else's view.
Yes.
To make a standard of what is good or what good looks like.
Because someone may look beautiful to you, but it may not beautiful, look beautiful to somebody another person.
And it applies to the sisters as well, sometimes with the makeup industry and with all of those designs. So sometimes discontentment comes through.
Yes. And everything, I believe, like, need to be done in a very moderate way and without any exaggeration. And unnecessary things should be avoided. And honestly, we as people today, we as human species at this time, we are indulged and engaged in so much unnecessary activities. And we need to really realize that and come back to the things that benefit us and people.
Now, my dear viewer, there's a fundamental point that has been mentioned by Sheikh here, that anything excessive, anything unnecessary must be avoided. And that needs, again, we use our common sense. And if there is in doubt, or if we think that we are slightly short of our understanding, or perhaps we are not understanding it accurately, as Sheikh has mentioned, consult people who are knowledgeable, who understand these fields, who are professionals. They can guide you, put you into the right track. And most importantly, as Sheikh has mentioned, we should always be content with what we have been blessed with, what we have. And inshallah, then we can continue our understanding and perhaps we can make our life better. We'll continue our discussion after a short break. Do stay tuned with us. We'll be right back in a few moments. You're watching Towards the Origin. Wassalamu alaikum.